Yes.
Are we rolling?
Is she rolling? Is the camera recording, Mr.
Are you rolling? Are you on drugs?
Well, soon. Soon.
Is that how you deal with me? I mean, I feel like I'm on drugs looking at you, queen.
I feel like I need drugs to be around you. Okay. Hi, I'm Lavender Whip.
And I'm Seymour Bottoms.
And this is Whipping Bottoms.
The universe where creativity has no boundaries. So Lavender, what are we doing today?
Well, you don't have to ask me twice. We are premiering our new series here on the channel. And what do we call it?
We call it
Blow Up to Glow Up.
What does that mean, darling?
So, we have this concept. We are going to compare queens or performers from the very beginning.
The blow up.
The blow up, when they started to perform or participate in
drag
or dress up. And compare them to their current state.
The glow up.
So from the trash to the treasure.
Yes, darling.
From the fucking frog to the fucking prince.
So from you to me.
No. From you to me.
What is that?
I think we can agree on that one, right?
So this is how it's going to work. We're going to select a very early stage photo in a performer's career, and we're gonna judge makeup, costume, everything, kind of the whole package.
Yes.
Keeping in mind the aesthetic of the performer.
Yes.
We're not boxing anyone, obviously.
No, we're not slut-shaming either.
Well, you slut-shame me all the time!
I mean, it's not that hard.
It's the smell.
The smell is hard. It's intense. Mm-hmm. We are going to do a mix, since we have multiple nationalities here on the channel.
Yes, we have Canada.
Trash. And we have Sweden.
Even bigger trash.
So, since we have Canadians, we have Swedes. We will mix Canadian queens and performers and Swedish queens and performers.
Yes, because we want to see the difference and compare. I mean, drag and art is different from all over, and we want to, of course, educate everyone to see what we have in Sweden and what we have in Canada and bridge them together in some beautiful glow-up.
Yes. And of course, we want to highlight and show off our beautiful queens and performers that we have.
Yes.
And talk about them, spread their names in the wind.
We have had our assistant select the photos for us for the fairness,
so we don't have
no clue.
So it's me, fresh eyes, fresh minds, and
dirty
whore.
But what we have done is ask the performers for their permission to use their photos.
So this is voluntary,
Do not come for us in the comments.
No.
They signed up for this themselves.
Yes. So we would also like to point out that everyone's drag journey is different from different times, different eras.
Of course.
So we had different tools and different resources before.
Absolutely. There were no Drag Race.
YouTube.
No makeup tutorials.
No AliExpress.
No internet. Barely.
I mean, depends on who it is.
I mean, right?
For me, I started 11 years ago now.
That's a long fucking time ago, girl.
I didn't really know what drag was. So I just kind of put things together and
made a wish.
Ran with it.
She better work.
And on that note,
we will start out with our first queen of the night.
So we're gonna start with me,
Miss Natalia Summer.
Oh my god. Okay, let's get into this.
I'm sweating.
So
what we see in front of us
is a mess.
It's a mess. She's giving you a fierce couture pose. She's like, she's like, oh, I'm just gonna go pick up some eggs and milk at the grocery store.
I'm just gonna go out to the club.
No, she would not be let in.
Nope.
They would be like, girl, walk three rounds around the block. She's wasted. What did you feel when you see this picture of you like 11 years ago?
So first I'm gonna break down the outfit. Why do I have a red crinoline bra popping out of this? Like,
so
bra.
I've seen some past pictures of her.
Oh, yeah.
And she loves her bras like peeking out of her top. She's like, well, I'm feminine, I'm a woman, I'm wearing a bra, and it's fucking awful and does not have anything to do with the rest of the outfit.
Well, I didn't contour my boobs. I didn't have a breastplate because that was something I didn't even know what that was.
No.
So I thought, why don't be colorful? Obviously.
I mean, and that's something you kept. You're still a fucking walking rainbow.
Yes.
So that's a theme going on.
The makeup though, if we're gonna talk about the makeup.
What makeup? It's barely fucking there.
So, wait. So, a little thing. I never did my makeup before because I didn't know how, and I had friends that wanted to help me, so it became like a collective thing. Friends would come together, we would do it. So, back then, I never did my makeup.
No, when did you start doing your own makeup?
1 year ago.
1 year ago, and we have this lovely face. And you did paint your nails in a color that did not match the entire
outfit.
And
then I didn't even see that. Oh,
they're teal.
No lashes. I don't even think there's mascara.
No mask for mascara.
No mask for mascara. Just mask for mask.
I mean, so if we compare this little creature to what we see in front of us here today, how do you feel you have changed the most?
I think I like this hair.
Me too. Thank you everyone for watching. We're done for
today. Bye!
Looks exactly the same. No, but I think obviously there's a huge evolution. You're not even doing the same character anymore.
No, no. So next we have I'm a Queen.
Ooh, I'm a Queen.
What can we say about I'm a Queen?
I'm a Queen is one of my very dear sisters. Yes. We started up drag together.
Yes,
we did. She actually started a year or so before me, but she did not like to talk about that year. For obvious reasons, but she's a very dear friend of mine, and we kind of grew up in drag together.
Yes.
Let's look at I Am a Queen back in the day.
Wait.
So, I have some fun facts about this photo. I actually took this photo.
Yes!
This is at the train station in Uppsala.
Oh, drag sisters traveling together.
And this is I'm a Queen, actually. Before she was called I'm a Queen, she had more names.
Uh-huh, just like me.
We've been through a few. She's been called Brunetta Brown. She's been called Diva Strass.
Okay,
yes. And then we had I'm a Queen.
Yes, I'm a Queen.
So...
First impressions?
First impression, yes, hooker boots.
That is a woman.
That's a woman. And I've said this before, but I'm gonna say it again. There are a few similarities between Natalia Summers.
Especially the pose, it's almost the same pose, yes!
Ooh. So, let's talk about the look.
So, I mean, overall, I think this is, it's very minimalistic for what she is now.
Oh, yeah.
But I think this is kind of clean and nice.
It's cute. So, one of her trademarks, she was always in that fucking blonde hair with the
chop, looking like, you know, the only Swedish MILF.
Yes, she always had a painter's background. She's always been good with color, definition, and that kind of stuff. She was just not, she just needed to practice her makeup skills, basically.
Yeah, she's got a really artistic, creative brain, so.
Oh yeah, she's a fucking weirdo. But overall, I think this is, it's a good look for her.
Yeah.
It was a very early stage.
Yes.
And for being this early in her career, I think she still looked good. But let's go to look at her glow up, because that's a big transformation.
She'll do the
shift. Let's swipe.
Oh. Ooh. Yes!
Moon fucking prism princess.
Mean, first of all, I want to say, how the fuck does this bitch wear all this shit on her head? Because she is building fucking globes and towers and
girl,
the universe is on her head.
I've been there. In the process, she fucking staples things to her head.
No, what?
No, not really, but almost. So she has long hair, just like me, she has long boy hair. So she's using like 50, 60 bobby pins, like fucking digging into her scalp. Her hair will be so thin by the time she's like 40. Because
her scalp.
Yes, she's like digging into her head, and that's fucking commitment, Iowa. And I love her for that.
What is this made from? Is this paper mache?
I think it's paper mache. Actually, her boyfriend made that for her,
yes,
Magnus.
Yes,
he's
Magnus.
Amazing. He actually creates a lot of her headpieces and accessories. It's beautiful and it's very lightweight. I tried it on once. It's very good. And I know lately she's been figuring out the ways to wear headpieces.
Yes.
To make them fit her head so she does not have to kill herself while doing it.
So, I mean, this look though, head to toe.
It's amazing.
The earrings, the headpiece, the makeup even kind of intertwines, and the lace that she has all over the headpiece. and then the garment, the long nails, everything is just...
It's a fully realized concept. It's amazing. She made that dress for sure. And it's actually a really beautiful bodice that she... I think she said she made it out of a rope and then she put a hot glue on top of it to create the structure.
Right.
So she uses a lot of non-conventional materials.
Yes.
A lot of like paper, a lot of like even natural materials. She uses a lot of
stuff.
Twigs. Yeah, she is great. She even wore an outfit made of rocks once.
And it was
so heavy, like so, so heavy. Let me just make some comments about the makeup. This is amazing.
This is stunning.
I would never have the patience to do this. I can sit down and do makeup for 5 and 6 hours, but this, the detail work is insane.
How many hours
insane.
Do you think this took her?
5, 6, probably. But her shadow play and her highlights and contours, the contrasts, her painter's background pops so clear in this photo. It's stunning, and the contacts, those fuckers are uncomfortable.
Yeah, and you can't see shit.
You cannot see anything. And she commits to the nail. I love a good nail.
Mm, I agree.
But yeah, the makeup is fantastic in this one. It's one of my favorite looks of her all time.
Okay, so let's swipe to our next
Let's look at our next victim.
Who do we have?
So I guess it's a Canadian queen because I have no clue who she is.
Yes, she is the reigning Miss Wig Wars in Thunder Bay. We have Miss Sophia Sapphire.
Please explain what that is, Wig Wars.
We have a competition called Wig Wars, and up until recently it used to be Queen and King, and they have decided, you know what, we're gonna switch it up. There is no rules and no gender laws. Let's just make one competition. Best performer wins.
No gender included.
No gender, no. So, Miss Stan here has won this year, last year.
She's a crowned queen.
She's a crowned queen. And for a first time in drag, this is cute.
It's decent. What I would assume, just by looking at the picture, she did not start out drag as early as you did.
No.
I would say this is definitely a queen who has seen some tutorials. She's been scrolling on Instagram.
Yes.
And she's been taking notes, because I would not say it's the greatest makeup I've ever seen, obviously.
It's not exaggerated, for sure. No. It's not
drag. It's still clean.
It's clean. It's nice.
I would of course ask for more, because I'm greedy.
Of course, you're greedy bottom. Mm-hmm. Even the wig line is like quite nice. Yeah. If you go back to my wig line, that was a
there
hot mess.
There were no wig line, it was just a fucking hat. Hair hat.
But I mean, this is cute, this is clean.
Yeah, but yeah, we could use bigger jewelry, a bit of a bigger makeup.
Yes.
We do not see a lot of the costume
hair. No, so we can't really judge.
But the only thing is like, elevates, exaggerates. Basically, but otherwise she looks cute. She looks like a nice girl. I went to have lunch with her.
Yeah, she...
Not dinner and a drink, but lunch.
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 That is a lunch with.
Ladies on lunch.
Ladies on lunch.
Ooh, let's go from her blow up to her glow up.
Work!
Ooh,
yes!
Bitch. You better fucking work.
Mm-hmm.
You know what she reminds me of?
Who?
Myself a tiny bit.
Yeah. This is great.
Yeah.
I mean,
I like it.
I
usually do not wear that much color, but...
Yeah, it's not your thing.
No, but it reminds me of myself a tiny bit.
I mean, head to toe. I love the detail on the lip.
The detail?
That is also a commitment if you're gonna go out and perform with that lip.
Oh yeah, that lip
is gonna go muddy.
Fucking move. I guess she used like drier consistencies, like liquid lipsticks, and probably set them real well, because she has that 3D effect with the white highlight on the lips well.
Yes.
It's really lovely.
The lines are clean.
I've actually never seen a lip like this.
Yeah, it's really cool.
It's very, very nice.
You better work, queen.
I'm hard to impress when it comes to makeup, and I think this is good.
She is a breastplate queen.
Now
she's got them titties.
But is she wearing a breastplate?
I think she is. If you look, she's a little busty.
She's a little busty.
Heavy
on the titty department.
She's also a pad queen as well. So
she's giving you the hourglass shape.
Yes.
We love that.
Yes. I think this is for sure.
This is fierce.
This is fierce. Yeah.
If I have any notes, I would say I think the costume is quite a bit tacky. But drag is a matter of taste.
Yes,
again.
Darling. I live, of course, because we all know I lack some color. I'm not even in color now, really. But
not even the color. I just think that the mix of the prints are a bit messy and too much, for my opinion. But I'm again quite streamlined.
I say work.
But it's fierce. I would tip her.
Yeah, I love it. Good job, queen.
Really lovely glow up. Let's go to our next.
Let's swipe, swipe, bish. Yes. So next we have another Thunder Bay performer, and we have a hyper queen.
Ooh, we have a hyper queen.
Do we know what a hyper queen is?
Well, I can take a guess.
So she is a biological woman, and a great representation that we have in our community. We have everyone from different walks of life, and
of course,
different backgrounds.
And that's also very beautiful, because drag brings people together. Anyone can do drag,
yes.
Basically. Faux brooches.
Ooh. So it's a play on that she is not.
And that wig is fucking faux. It's
but like, can we talk
it's
about...
It's shiny, shiny plastic.
What's with the yellow?
I mean, this is obviously a party store wig.
Yes.
It's very, very plasticky. If you would run by this wig with a lighter, it would fucking explode.
I was there with her. We performed together.
Ooh.
And we did... telephone, Lady Gaga.
Ooh, did you ring her telephone?
Oh, yes, darling. Mm. But we did the video version.
You know, you can fix a mirror if it's broke.
Yeah.
But you can still see the crack in the
motherfucking reflection.
Yeah, but this is fun. I really like the colors and the eye. I do not understand what shape it is, really. But I guess it's some sort of a pride rainbow.
Yes, this is the first ever pride that we had.
It's the first ever Thunder Bay pride.
Yes, this was the premiere.
And again, Thunder Bay, the city that you're from.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes. This was her first time ever performing. First time doing this kind of makeup. She has a burlesque background, so she started as a burlesque performer.
That's lovely.
And yeah, she threw this together.
Yes, let's leave the blow up in the past and look at the glow up.
Oh, yes!
Oh, bitch!
Yes!
That's fucking fierce.
So, realty, I did see this on Instagram the other day, so I live for this makeup.
So this is very recent.
And this was just the other day, and I was hoping this was selected because I live for this. Look at this mug!
It's very mug. I love the PC lashes. Mm-hmm. It's very beautiful. It's very well blended. I love the monochromatic moment. I live for a monochromatic moment.
Those lines.
The hair matches the makeup. Mm-hmm. It's very beautiful.
And she's corseted.
She's cinched. Mm-hmm. The only thing I wish for was that she picked up the green color somewhere in the costume.
Yes.
But other than that, I think it's beautiful.
Mm, it's gorgeous.
Does her collar say faux queen? Or faux?
I think it's
her name. Faux,
so I hope so.
Yeah.
I don't actually know for sure, but I hope so. That's
probably
fucking fierce. So she does makeup as well. So she taught herself, and she does makeup on some queens that don't know how to paint their own face as well. Mm-hmm.
I guess she can turn some queens out because she looks too really talented at makeup.
Yes. And she also sews, and she can make some really fierce stuff.
She's a well-rounded girl.
She's a well-rounded queen.
And I guess since she comes from a burlesque background, she knows how to perform the house down.
She does. She
because
does.
The burlesque girls, they do turn the party.
Yes. And here's a little fun fact about us. I met her in burlesque. She met me in drag.
Oh.
I got her into drag, she got me into burlesque.
Ooh, the crossover.
Yes.
That's very interesting.
And so now she mainly performs in drag and I mainly perform in burlesque. Mm. So it's literally worlds crossed over.
Let's look at the next blow up, I'm nervous.
I'm excited. Oh, oh.
Ooh.
Ooh, yes,
mom and dad.
So who do we have here?
So here we are looking at the Vilbergs, formerly known as
Duo Raw for most people.
Yeah,
probably
so
probably know them as that old.
Exactly. Name. Back when this picture was taken, they were they went by the name of Duo Raw.
I mean, they're icons.
They are
international icons.
They are fashion icons. They are literally walking pieces of art.
Club kid icons, drag icons, fashion icons, icon head to toe. And this is one of the first photos. I mean,
so I guess this was back in like 2012 or 11, maybe?
The 1800s.
The 1800s.
Where they have the big poof.
A bitch never ages.
I mean, this is polished.
This is very, very pretty. So
I have one complaint. Read mom and dad.
You want to pasty on the titty?
I want to pasty
you
on the titty.
You want to pasty on the titty.
I mean, that's the only thing I would say. And I don't always wear pasties, but I think that it is really top heavy and they have hot little bodies, so I mean,
yeah, they wear twinks.
Show it off!
So they wanted to bring a new concept of like club culture and club life to Sweden that we didn't really have. So they started off like creatures of the night. They were turning looks, they were very avant-garde and very like in your face. It was studs and spikes and it was very kind of aggressive. And they wanted to turn heads and get people's attention, and they for sure did.
They have been on Vogue, they have been in Fashion Week, they have been all over the world.
They are traveling the world, they are very big in Asia, they're living the life. And I'm very proud to call them my drag parents. So they were always like doubles. And this was in the beginning, so that's also where they created the name, I guess. They were a duo. Yeah. So they always did the same look, and then it kind of evolved throughout time, and then they started dabbling to drag as well.
To that! Yes! So this is the glow up, baby!
This is the glow up, baby. So this is from Pride last year.
Yeah. This is a collaboration with Vella.
It's a collaboration with Vella, the hair care brand.
Yes.
They did a campaign for them, and they also ride with them in the Pride Parade.
This is iconic.
We cannot even start. So the costumes, it's couture, honey. It's real couture. It's no glue guns here, honey.
No. This was
it's beaded with rhinestones, glass, Swarovski.
What I love about them, even back then and now, is their attention to detail, and also too, their concepts are so
effortless.
Yeah.
They deliver a concept, you don't even need to like read a description. You can just look at them and get it right away.
Yeah, I love that. It's accessible, but it's also very avant-garde and amazing.
It's amazing. They're truly one of a kind.
Yes.
And if we're gonna compare it from back in the day, I love how they have turned into drag. So I have nothing but love for these people. They have helped me so much in my career and have lifted me very much. They're amazing. We love you guys. So this was our brand new concept, Blow Up to Glow Up. There will be a few more videos like this.
Yes.
We will be talking about more queens, more Canadian queens, more Swedish queens. We will be talking about yours truly when she started out in drag.
Yes, check that out in the next episode.
Ooh, the next episode, it's gonna be rough, girl.
We just want to say thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this kind of content, please comment down below, like, share, let us know. We want to know you and we want to get your feedback.
Of course.
That's so important.
Of course, you should always follow us on all social medias.
Yes,
Pornhub. No, I'm just
kidding. My social media, bitch. Don't come for my gig. So all the performers in today's episode and us as well, everything will be linked down below.
Yes.
So please give all the performers and us some love and we will see you on the next one.
Yes.
Bye. Ta-ta for now!